Samson's strength and downfall, Judges 13 through 16. The Israelites were stuck in a cycle of disobeying God, being invaded by another country, crying out to God for help, obeying him for a while, and then disobeying him again. This time, the Philistines had been causing Israel trouble for 40 years, but God had a plan to help the Israelites fight the Philistines. Manoah and his wife were not able to have children. God chose this couple to have a very special child. One day, the angel of the Lord appeared to Manoah's wife. "You will have a son," the angel told her. "He will deliver Israel from the Philistines." Manoah's wife told her husband all she had seen and heard. He prayed that God would let him meet the man too. When the angel appeared again to his wife, she ran to get Manoah, who listened as the angel repeated everything again. The couple made an offering to the Lord. They were amazed to see the angel ascend to the heaven in the flames. The woman named her baby Samson, and God blessed Samson as he grew up. The angel had said Samson had to follow three special rules. Samson could not drink strong drink like alcohol or wine, he could not cut his hair, and he could not go near a dead body. When Samson grew up, he wanted to marry a Philistine woman. "Get her for me," Samson told his parents. "Can't you pick a wife from our people instead of from the Philistines?" his parents asked. Samson insisted, so they went to her city. On the way, a young lion came toward him. The Spirit of God rushed upon Samson so powerfully that he ripped apart the lion barehanded. When Samson returned later to marry the woman, he found a swarm of bees and honey inside the dead lion. Even though he wasn't supposed to go near a dead body, Samson broke God's rule. He scraped out the honey and ate it. At his wedding, Samson gave a riddle to the guests and offered gifts if they could answer it. The guests threatened Samson's new wife to get the answer. When they told the answer to Samson, he was so angry he went to another town, killed 30 men to get the gifts, and went home to his parents. When Samson returned, his wife had married a Philistine man. So Samson tied 300 foxes in pairs with a lit torch between each pair of tails. The foxes ran through the Philistines' field, setting fire to their grain. The angry Philistines killed his wife and her father. So Samson killed 1,000 Philistines by himself. Samson's strength baffled the Philistines so much that their leaders bribed Delilah, another woman Samson loved, to find out Samson's secret. "Tell me the secret of your strength," Delilah begged. "If you were to bind me with 7 fresh bowstrings, I would be as weak as any man," Samson answered. Delilah hid the Philistines in the room to arrest Samson, tied him with the bowstrings while he was sleeping, and then shouted to him. "The Philistines are here, Samson!" Samson broke the bowstrings as easily as if they had been thread. Delilah tried again. "If you tie me with new ropes, I won't be able to break them," Samson lied. Delilah believed him, so that is what she did. "The Philistines are here, Samson," Delilah shouted. Again, Samson easily broke the ropes. "You are lying to me about your strength. Tell me the truth," Delilah cried. Now Samson had 7 long locks of braided hair. He told her to weave his hair into the fabric of a loom. A loom is a heavy wooden machine on which people can weave fabric and rugs. It would be difficult for Samson to get his hair out of it. One night while Samson slept, Delilah wove his hair into the fabric and shouted again. Samson jumped up and left with the loom still in his hair. "How can you say you love me when you don't trust me with your secret?" Delilah whined. She pestered him every day until he told her the truth. "I've been dedicated to God from the time I was born," Samson told her. "If you shave my head, then my strength will leave me." Delilah knew he told the truth this time. She hid the Philistines again, and while Samson slept, she shaved off his hair. This time Samson's strength was gone. The Philistines seized him, blinded him, and took him to prison. The Philistines gathered together to celebrate Samson's capture. They brought out Samson, chained him to the pillars of the temple, and made fun of him. Samson prayed, "God, remember me and strengthen me one more time." Samson pushed against the pillars. The temple came crashing down, killing everyone, including Samson. God gave Samson a special strength for helping Israel. But that special strength didn't excuse Samson from obeying God. Samson failed to love God above all else. Even though Samson failed to love God, God never failed to love Israel. We can always trust God to love us, and we should respond to his love by obediently and lovingly serving him.